y'all, it's your girl Kay, and I'm back with another video. Today, I'm gonna be giving some wedding planning advice. If you guys didn't know, I'm in the process of planning a wedding, and I'm not gonna lie, it's much tougher than what I expected, but I'm making it through, and I'm trying to make it as fun and less stressful as possible. So if you're interested, stay tuned. The number one question I got when we first got engaged was, when is the wedding? I don't know, I just got a ring on my finger. Like, how am I supposed to know? That's a very, I guess people don't know what to say. They're like, congratulations, when's the wedding? I don't know, it's a surprise. I mean, I guess some people plan that out or already know when they're gonna have their wedding or what season, but for me, I had no idea, it was a surprise. So no, I didn't know. So my first step was getting a wedding planner binder. What I use is this binder that I got from my Miss to Mrs. Bot. Honestly, this binder isn't enough for me. I would invest maybe in getting a real wedding planner, because it's so much more that you need to write down as you're planning your wedding. I would write down important dates. I would do a month-to-month checklist, which you can find these checklists on Pinterest and other websites on what you should be doing as you're planning your wedding and the timeline of when things should get done. So I would have all that written down in the planner. I will also have like a to-do list of things you need to get done as well that might not necessarily be on a timeline. Step two, I would suggest coming up with a vision board. How do you want your wedding? Do you want a big wedding, a small wedding? Where do you want your wedding? Do you want outside, at a church, at a venue? And what time frame, what season would you like your wedding? So get a big picture. I would suggest doing a Pinterest board. Get some inspiration of things you like and have it all in one place. So when you do go to these different vendors, you can kind of show them what you're expecting or what you're looking for. Then you wanna start thinking about creating a budget. How much can you afford? Are you gonna have people helping you with this wedding? Like, are you gonna be having parents or in-laws helping you with this wedding? Or are you and your fiance putting up the cost by yourself? So you wanna make sure you get that figured out. It's a tough question. Most parents or in-laws will say what they're gonna do, so it makes it a little bit easier, but if not, I would definitely suggest asking if, or you'll be covering that cost, and that will also determine where you have your wedding, how many people, and all that good stuff as well. Then I started a guest list of who I wanted to come on my fiance's side and my side. Well, he did his guest list. And then we put them together. I used the app Wedding Wire because it was so helpful when creating a guest list. It kept count of it and it had bride and groom. And if you were able to put in the phone number, the address, if they were bringing people. And also it was easy to edit as you get in invitations and saying yes, they can come or no or whatever. It was a very easy one place where you can organize and it counted for you. I found it super helpful, especially when sending out invitations. When planning a wedding, I would definitely suggest getting advice from people who planned a wedding before. So maybe getting an advisor, a wedding planning coordinator, so many things you won't even think about. And to make it easier, I joined some Facebook groups, Brides on a Budget and some other Facebook groups, which were really helpful. You got to see what other people were doing and some ideas that can save you time and little tricks and stuff you would never even think about, honestly. This is my first wedding. Once you have your guest list down, your budget down, do your research. There's so many hidden costs that you wouldn't even think about. Make sure you do your research. You can find a venue and they have a day that you would like. Go ahead and book that. You wanna book it at least a year in advance, especially with everything going on. I didn't know you had to think about all this stuff, like basically right after you get engaged, if you plan on getting married within that year, you wanna start booking things, but make sure you do your research. Don't just go booking away. I would suggest if you can't afford to get a wedding planner or coordinator, I would definitely suggest getting it the day of the wedding because that will definitely eliminate your stress. I hope you guys found these tips helpful. They helped me with my wedding planning process. Comment down below some things that you did for your wedding, some tips and things for new brides out there. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.